Hello, I'm Helen Bradley. Welcome to this video tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create rays with an application online and then how to color them in Illustrator. Before we get started on this project, let's have a look and see what it is that we're aiming for. This is a set of rays that I have created online using an application I'm going to show you in a minute. And then I brought them into Illustrator and I've distorted and recolored them here. The possibilities here are endless and it's a really cool application online, so I think you're going to like it. So let's switch now to Chrome and I'm going to show you the tool that we're going to use. This is the tool and it's called InkRaise, and you can find it at thoka.net/inkraise.html. Now this is the InkRaise that I used in Illustrator just there, but we're going to create a new set. You'll see that when you go to the website, you'll get some presets and you can click on these. If you click to choose any of these presets, you'll wipe out any settings that you already have. So we've lost the one that we just created, but that's not too bad because I've saved it already anyway. But these are some of the default options showing the possibilities that you can achieve using this tool. So I'm just going to select one of these to start with and we're going to run down the list here. The radius in pixels is going to be the rays length. So if we want longer rays or shorter rays, we can type in here. You can say I typed 300 and the rays are a bit shorter. The outer inner circle radius is the relationship between these two. So we can make the inner circle a bit smaller by decreasing this value. I'm going to make it 0.2. The ray count is the number of rays. At the moment it's set to 400. Let's make this a lot less. Let's make it 60 so we can see what's happening here. The ray gap ratio is the gap ratio around here, and I find that something like 0.4, 0.3, something like that will work pretty well. If you want your rays to be a random length, you can do so here. Let's make them 50% varied. You can see now that they're not a solid round, but in actual fact they're all different lengths. Now we're seeing these blocks because that's what we've got selected, block. If we want to see spiky rays, then we'll click spike and that will show us spiky rays. We can choose single or multipath. And every time we choose multipath, every time I click on this option, you'll see that the rays are being redrawn. That's because we have random ray length selected at 50% and we're getting a different rendering of the rays. The opacity is how opaque the stroke is, and the fill is, I'm just going to do one, and the stroke is the width of the stroke. Now we can deal with that in Illustrator shortly, so I'm not going to worry too much about that. We can also deal with the stroke color in Illustrator, but you could do it here if you wanted to set the stroke color and if you want a fill color. Now at the moment we're seeing a random fill, but if we just selected fill color, you'll see that we're seeing this orange fill, and we can click here and change the fill color if we want to. Or we can just go with a random fill. I think I'll go with my fill color here. The background color is the background here. We're not really too worried about that. And the bends we can create here. Let's make a bend of 30 and then let's make this one 20 or maybe minus 15. So you can play with those settings here. If you want to, you can click random orientation and then the rays bend in different directions. I want them all to go in the same direction. So I'm going to call this good for now and I'm going to click to download it. And I'll need to click keep. And I want to see it in the folder. And it'll go into your downloads folder. And here it is here. Now I'm going to just hide Chrome for now. I'm going to hide this Illustrator document. Let's go back to my downloads folder. I'm just going to drag and drop this into Illustrator. And this is the Illustrator image. It's an SVG file, which means that it is a vector image. So let me just got the background selected there. I'm just going to delete that because I find it easier to get rid of the background. And now if I select over this, you can see this is just a regular vector image. and we can do things with it. One of the things that we can do is, for example, turn off the stroke so we only have the fills, and then we can play with the fill on it. Now, one of the things that I did with the fill was to add a gradient to it. So let's go and select a gradient. Now, in the gradient tools in Illustrator, you'll see that there aren't very many gradients at all, and particularly not when you open this particular image, because it doesn't come with any swatches in it. So what I'm going to do is go and open a gradient. So I'll go to Show Gradient Swatches, and then I'll go and choose Open Swatch Library, Gradients, and let's go and find a set of gradients. So I'm going to choose Brights for this one, and when I click to open Brights, it opens in a separate swatch. Now, with the foreground color selected, I can apply one of these gradients to the image. Now, at the moment, it's a linear gradient. If I want to change that, I'll make sure that the Gradients panel is visible, which you get to by choosing Window and then Gradient. And now we can make it a radial gradient if we want to. And this gives us additional options for coloring the image, so that we could put in additional stops. We can adjust the gradient. We could do anything we like at this point. Now, the other thing that you can do with these is that you can use the effects. Choose Effect, and then Distort and Transform and Pucker and Bloat. This is how I got that interesting effect. I turned Preview on, and then I selected to bloat the shape, and I got this sort of interesting thing happening with my rays. But you can experiment with these settings to see what it is that you get. If you want that at all, you may want just your regular rays. It's up to you, so I'm just going to click OK. And now we have this shape here. Now, if we want to, we can put the stroke back on it by targeting stroke and then going and getting a stroke color to use, such as a blue or even a red stroke. So you can see there's lots of potential here for using the rays that you're getting from the website, this InkRaise tool, which creates SVG images that are vector shapes that you can then open in Illustrator and recolor and do all sorts of things with. I'm Helen Bradley. Thank you for joining me for this video tutorial. Look out for more of my tutorials on this YouTube channel. Subscribe to the channel so that you'll be alerted when new videos are released. And visit my website at projectwoman.com for more tips, tricks, and tutorials on Photoshop, Illustrator, Photoshop Elements, Lightroom, and a whole lot more.